Regent House 0, Bangor Grammar 18. Bangor 18, Campbell 14.
Coverage of today's Danske Bank Ulster Schools 7 tournament here at Campbell College. We'll have all the action kicking off very shortly, but first let me introduce our two guests for today. They are Giles Strutt, who I still haven't managed to shake off after a whole season, and Adam Brennan. Right, Adam, first things first, Adam, all seriousness, why are you not playing today?
Two concussions in a row, Simon.
Okay, and would you like to have been out there, or is sevens not really your thing?
Sadly, sevens wasn't really my thing, just not aerobically fit enough.
Okay. Giles, you've been here a couple of times before. What are your memories of previous tournaments here?
It's always good fun, and controversial sometimes as well.
And it hasn't really ever gone too well for us some years, has it?
No.
Okay, now, obviously sevens is quite a bit different to normal rugby. For a start, there are seven players rather than the standard 15 in the team, and also halves are 7 minutes long rather than the regulation 40 or 35 in schools rugby. Now, in the Bangor Grammar group, we also have RBAI, Regent, and another team, Dalriada, who I forgot to write down in my notebook. Of those four teams, two progress into the knockouts. Who are your picks for qualification now?
Well, I'd like to say Bangor and Inst.
Bangor and Inst, okay. Adam, what about you? Same thing?
Yes.
Okay, thanks very much. Now, we'll take a look at the team.
The players.
Yeah.
I would say Conor McKee. Obviously, he's a strong asset to this team. Robert Gamble as well. Shown he's a good player in this sort of tournament last season and the season before that. So
yeah. There's certainly a lot of pace in this team, Adam, isn't there?
Lulu Brett is going to be one to watch today. He's like a knife through butter. He's going to cut any team apart. I'll tell you that much.
Thank you.
Oh yeah.
What, this?
Another memory card?
I don't know.
Can I
give it a go?
Can I format it? No.
I don't know.
Okay.
Yeah, go on then. Here, I better.
Can I go ahead and format this?
Yeah, go ahead.
Format. Cheers, only 291 photographs. So.
So bad, yeah. We're doing well here. I don't know, but Agnew's got 3 tries so far, and I think they've got 2 now, so. Thank you.
Grammar School versus BRA, 1240, pitch 5. Go up to 1240. Your teams make their way to the respective pitches. Thank you.
Last play!
think we both
scored five. They've scored three, I think.
No, they've scored four.
Have they?
Yeah, I think. Okay, Matthew Agnew, that was a fine start for both the team and yourself. Four tries. You can't say that every day, can you?
No, I only scored one the whole season, so it's a good start anyway.
And how does this compare? You played sevens for the medallions last year, didn't you?
Yeah.
How does this compare? Is it a step up?
Definitely, yeah. Last year we just played 15s, you know, with seven players, so this time we're playing a bit of sevens, you know, with Mr. Bond coaching us, we know where we're going.
And do you think you can get a few more tries today?
Hopefully, yeah. Hopefully.
Well, it's so far so good, so well done.
Thank you.
You got man of the match as well. That's the first game then between Bangor Grammar and Dalrieta, and it was a good win.
33-27
was the final score in that. Who was your standout performer?
Has to be Aggie. He was always there at the right time, right place, and scored four tries.
And it's not something that we've really seen much of him do through the season, score tries, but today he had a killer instinct.
Yeah, sevens I think has really exposed the inner try scoring ability in him, and he was just under the post every time.
Are we starting to see maybe a better example of why he's in the Ulster Schools team? Because we haven't seen him on the scoreboard too often, and maybe now.
I don't know if you compare sevens rugby to Ulster Schools level, but no, I think he had a good performance today, and as well as that, Lewis Breathitt as well, despite the score, like his name on the scoreboard, he had a good number of assists.
Yeah. The other try came from Ross Maxwell. He's actually had a very good season scoring tries. Certainly, I think he's third or fourth on the list of top scorers. Adam, as a guy who hasn't scored so many tries, are you jealous?
Not jealous, no, but I admire him. He's always there. Yeah, he's always under the posts. I think he's just one of those players that has a try-scoring ability. Like, you know, he has this little flair in him that's always there, and it's always one of the white line fever. That's what you call it. So, sickness. He's sick.
So anytime you see him take up your place in second row then, do you think... Well, you play with him more often than not, don't you?
Yeah, most of the time, Brian Crawford play with me for the end of the year whenever...
Ross went back to flanker, didn't
he? Yeah.
Do you think Ross, in terms of 15-side rugby, is Ross a better flanker or second row?
I'd say second row, because at the breakdown, like, there's not many turnovers he's produced.
Yeah.
And also, in the line-out, he's our main man.
Yeah. Now, the next game is against RBAI, the Schools Cup champions. Is this going to be the toughest task of the day, then, so far?
Most definitely, I'd say, yeah.
And do you think, then, that... well, obviously, you wouldn't expect Bangor to win this, but if they do, then that puts them in a very good position to qualify.
Yeah, it was something very miraculous for Bangor to win this game, but it'll be a tough game, to say the least.
Do you think... Inster are probably the favourites to win this event overall, or do you think Campbell as hosts have a bit of an unfair advantage?
Well, I wouldn't really rule out any team, to be honest. I think Inster could be a disadvantage of them coming so quick off the heels of the Schools Cup. Yeah. They haven't much time to prepare for the Sevens game of play, but I don't know, we'll see out of all those big teams who prevails.
Of course, because this is so thick and fast, these games, we don't know what score Inster have got in their first game, so... We'll find out now then. Here you are, I'm not even in shot. These are the highlights of the Bangor Grammar vs. Watch.
Oh, I offer. You're all right. Guys, we've got to move the ball to the space quicker and then go forward. The space at the side.
I'll go.
The difference between these two teams? I mean, Ulster probably not had a lot of practice because they played the school's cup final on Tuesday.
I think it was just a very strong team throughout. Bangor were like thrown together, I think. Yeah. We lost John Fair, I think, which affected our game. But I think whenever Will came on, he actually did bring.
He set up a try in there.
Set up a try, the only try of the match for Bangor, and he did a good job of what he got.
Rob Gamble got the try. Are you pleased for him? Yeah.
Yeah, Rob's just a try scorer. He's always running down the wing or breaking lines.
And unconverted by Aaron Corbett. It was surprising perhaps to see him taking the kick and not Rob himself.
Well, see, I have to say at the school house competition, Aaron Corbett stepped up to the mark to take a kick right in front of the post, and that's he scuffed it and missed it, which shows that he's confident, but he's at the same time very poor kicking and he should never kick again.
Who do you think will get the conversions in this game then? Will it be Jimmy Fulton? Or?
Definitely not Corbett.
No, I think Robert. Robert didn't take kick, I don't think. Well, I assume for the last match because he was gassed from running basically half pitch.
Also, I think he missed his conversion on the first game, didn't he?
It was a very bad miss.
It was a tough angle, though. So.
You can't make excuses.
Let's move onwards now. Pitch. And the next game is against Regent on the pitch just beside you. Can't see on the camera. This is a big derby game. This is more than pride at stake here.
It is. It's the local clash of the Titans.
Will this be a grudge match?
This is definitely. You're going to see a couple of fists thrown, a couple of knees to the face, and most importantly, a couple of tries scored by the grammar.
I sincerely hope you're not going to be right there, although the tries, perhaps.
I hope so.
So, really, whether Bangor progress comes down to this game, I'm not sure on the scores in other games, but you would imagine that the winner of this game will progress. Taking bias out of account, who would be. I mean, Region have done better in the Shield this year, haven't they? So.
They have.
But they had an easier run-in, perhaps, and they got beaten.
See,
Region,
they got the easiest teams in the Schools Cup and the Shield. Their only team that they had that was difficult was Inst, and that just shows.
I'll remind you that they got knocked out to the same team that we did, don't I? In the Shield.
Give me that, listen here!
Oh! Did he get that?
What?
Did he get that?
Yeah.
Oh, very good.
I'm happy to see myself.
Get the ball!
Three!
Get the ball, Nate! Go!
very quickly, because the game's about to start, who do you think might win this one?
Obviously Bangor, I'm going to say, but it'll be a tight game. Similar to the Ince game, I think.
Yeah, okay, and what kind of a team were Ballymena whenever you played them earlier in the season, Adam?
Big hitting, they were won, didn't they? Big side. So I think that might go against them in this match.
Okay. And we hear it's an unchanged team from the last game, except for Charlie Blair, who's replacing Will Logan. So Charlie scored in the last game. Were you pleased with that?
Yeah, I have to say, Will let himself down.
You let himself down? Is that your transfer?
No, I was trying to say something else. No. What I was going to say was Will let himself down the other game.
Yeah.
He played well in the end game, though.
Yes, he did play well. But well, see, I mean, his tackling in
he's
the
still there as a sub, so the coaches say a need for him. Thanks very much. Okay, let's go straight. I thought you were going to throw that in my face. Let's go straight now to Bangor against Ballymena.
Thank you. Yeah!
unfortunate end there, guys, but a good performance up to the quarterfinal game. What are your highlights of today then, starting with you, Robin?
That final try there, definitely. It was a brilliant team try. It worked well.
I think the comedy aspect of that as well just added to it.
Yeah.
It's pretty funny.
Adam, what about you?
Final try was brilliant, but I have to say, see Jonny Baxter missing those tackles and getting handed off into the ground, that was brilliant.
Wonderful.
Also, Aaron Corbett being sick in the first match as well.
That was a highlight.
That was a great highlight as well.
That was very funny.
So a quarterfinal exit for Bangor to the hands of Ballymena Academy. They looked a better team than Ince, would you say?
No.
Certainly,
I think they were worse at Dalriada, to be honest.
I'd agree. Yeah,
really? I agree.
I'd agree. Just we played a lot more worse than we played against our other.
We're done out. I think
there's a low morale
in the
camp.
Got the better of us.
Who was your man of the day then?
Has to be Wilgan.
For being serious here, Matthew Agnew.
Yeah, well, I would agree with that one.
I think Will was the impact sub, but maybe Matty might have been the star of the game.
Don't forget, in 2 weeks we'll be at Strickland Glen again for our second annual touch match. You're all invited.
Can't wait.
So we'll see you then, and for now it's goodbye.
Oh, I'm captaining the first for the goodbye. Touch match.
Yeah.
Goodbye.
Right, I'm running, I'm going to leave.
But how were we to know that these are the days that bind you together forever? And these little things that bind you forever, forever. I don't wanna hear you talk about it anymore. Oh.